This is a pre-built version of the application. So we'll have three peers, two that are trying to communicate, and the third one will be an eavesdropper peer. And this will be the first one, second one, and the eavesdropper one. So this will be picking up messages from both communicating peers. And this one will be picking up messages from this one. And this one from this one. So those two peers will be using the elliptic curve digital signature algorithm to sign and verify the signature on messages. And this eavesdropper peer would want to sign messages pretending to be Alice or Bob. And I put the test data that we will be using in this file. So we'll be using this curve used by Bitcoin, and the numbers here and here will be the same, except here we have it in hex format and here in decimal format, and same for this curve. Here we have it in decimal format and here in hex format. So this is A and B and P and N and H, the domain parameters. So let's go ahead and copy those. This is a curve used by Alice. And we'll copy the generator point. In decimal format. And let's say she picks this secret key, and she calculated the public key. So the public key is this many halves from the generator point. The public key ends up being this point. And for Bob, let's have him use this curve. So we'll take the domain parameters, we'll copy those, generator point. And let's say he picks this secret key, and he calculate and send his public key, so the X and Y coordinate for B. So it's D hops from the generator point. Now passive Eve can see the domain parameters for the curve used by Alice and for the one used by Bob to sign messages. And Alice now has a public key for Bob, and Bob has a public key for Alice. So let's say Alice wants to send this to sign and send this message to Bob. So here we hashed the message using SHA-256, and let's choose the ephemeral key. So let's say it's this number. To sign it, we need this secret key. So let's say we enter the wrong key. So this was signed and sent to Bob, and Bob determined that this message was not signed with Alice's private key. So he hashes the message that he received and calculates W, U1, U2, and the point P, and validates if V is congruent to R in mode N. And since this is not true, he determines that the message was not signed by Alice. So what Alice sent was the message, and R and S to Bob. So here we go. She calculated the point R and then S and sent R and S. And let's have Alice send the same message with the same ephemeral key, but now sign it with her private key. So Bob validates and determines that the message was signed with Alice's private key. And passive Eve can see all that communications of both messages. So passive Eve has domain parameters that Alice is using, so the curve and the generator point, and she also has the domain parameters that Bob is using, the curve and the generator point. And she can see communications originating from Alice, but in order to sign those messages as being Alice, she needs to solve the ECDLP, elliptic curve discrete logarithm problem, and compute her private key D, or ephemeral key. And let's have Bob send this message to Alice, and let's say he uses this ephemeral key, and so this was his private key. So Alice determines that the message was signed with Bob's private key. And same thing, passive Eve can see that communications. And we can do the same calculations, except use this test data for both Alice and Bob in hex format, base 16. So to do that, all what we have to do is to change the base here to 16. Now the source code will be available for download, also a longer and comprehensively explained version of this prototype project, including writing the code, will be available for watching by all channel members.